Well, it's not grand rising, but happy Sunday, loves. This is the altar spread for the collective today. It's a little delayed and late, but I wanted to hold off on the spread because I have company here in my sacred space with me, my girl Janaea. And so I'm just showing her my process and sharing this with her. And so that she can also see how I pull the cards and my process of how that works. But the sacred geometry that showed up today is steam cave in reverse. And so steam cave, if you see the beautiful, it's like the Sri Yantra, the interlinking triangles, which talk about all of the elements, right? So again, the upward pointing triangles represent air and fire. That's the masculine driven energy. And the downward pointing triangles of water and earth. But interlinking, they represent ether and all that is. So masculine, feminine energies. And so steam caves showing up in the reverse talks about the loss of connectedness to those elements. And so each element connects to a very specific energetic space in the body. So the root chakra, which is at the base of the tailbone, which encompasses the physical space from that pelvic floor all the way to the tips of the toes, that's earth energy. The sacral, which is the pelvic floor, hip to hip, which spans around the low back, and it's from the navel and below, so about the waist and below, so the low back as well. That is water. That's the sacral chakra. And then the solar plexus, which is above the navel and goes around the lower edge of the rib cage, so that midsection of the torso, that's fire. And then the heart space, which is at the base of the neck, and it also encompasses the entire length of the arms into the fingertips, and that's wind energy. And so think about how you connect with those elements, and do you have an aversion to any of those elements, like perhaps not liking rainy days or not liking windy days? Or do you have an aversion to fire? Or are you afraid to swim in deep waters? And so how about getting dirty? How do you feel about sticking your feet, your bare feet, in dirt or mud? Or even getting your hands in dirt or mud? How do you feel about those things? How about hiking? Do you have an aversion to walking in nature? And so that brings a lot of awareness to your connection to those elements in those spaces of your body. And when you start to realize that those elements connect with a very specific energy of body, any aversion would be actually a message that there's a disconnect with the energy of that space in your body. Okay? And so the disconnect then becomes, like, of course, the heart. That's not only the receiving, but the giving of your compassionate self. Can your ability to see others as you see yourself? The fire energy, this is your power, but this also houses knowledge of path and purpose. Do you feel disconnected from your path and purpose? Do you know why you're here? Do you feel completely lost in that aspect? The sacral houses knowledge of true self. So any low self-worth, any self-doubt, any abuse energy is stored there, which prevents connection with self. So that water, any aversions to water would be amplifying the fact that you have a disconnection with self. And then of course that earth energy, that's that root that goes all the way to the tips of the toes. And this is, are you provided for? Are you nurtured? Are you sheltered? Are you fed? Are you supported? And so when you start to make those connections, you can know yourself in a deeper way, and it helps you commune with yourself in a deeper way and start to heal those issues and aspects. And if you do that by first connecting with the elements can teach you how to purify those spaces, those energetic spaces in your body, so that you can heal. and it helps facilitate the healing process. And that's how we use the allies of the human experience, so that you're not just having a mindless human experience, but a very connected and conscious human experience. And so that's the message of Steam Cave. Now, Smoky Mirror also showed up in the reverse. And Smoky Mirror talks about the shadow aspect of self. Our shadow is the aspect of ourself that we deny. And usually this shows up because we don't want to see that that is actually a part of who we are. And so it's normally something that we've been taught is negative or bad. Right? So let me choose one. Oh, okay. I'll use my son's shadow. My son's shadow is arrogance. Okay. And he is so triggered by arrogant energy outside of himself, because your shadow will always, always show up in your reality outside of you to show you what you are repressing within yourself. Right? And so if you've developed negative judgments about something, that becomes your shadow, and then your shadow shows up, right? So I asked him, what's the one word that you use to describe these people that are completely triggering you and making you so enraged? He's like, arrogance. And I was like, okay, what's arrogance? Arrogance is confidence without any basis to boast, right? These are people who are just usually entitled behaviors, right? And so I asked him, I said, do you think maybe that you even repress your own confidence? Because confidence is the high side of arrogance, right? And so a lot of times we repress the good thing, naming it the bad, if that makes sense. So my own son was naming his confidence, because he is uber intelligent. He was naming his confidence arrogance. And so not speaking up for himself, he was allowing his own confidence, because he does have basis to boast. He was actually tapping that down and naming it arrogance. So arrogance started showing up outside of him, where he was being shown really what arrogance is. And so he was able to then say, wow, that's right. I can actually claim confidence for myself because I'm not arrogant. And so it's no longer a shadow aspect of himself. And he's able to integrate that energy and no longer repress that, because now he recognizes the difference and also recognizes that he was repressing this huge part of himself and disempowering himself because he was naming it something ugly instead of taking the high side of that. So that's the shadow aspect. So the smoky mirror showing up in reverse is saying, are you allowing parts of yourself to control you because maybe there's self-doubt, or you've bought into any kind of lies and deceit about your own behavior or personality or aspects of yourself that have now become a shadow aspect of yourself? And you are so deeply in denial that you're not owning it. And so if those things are showing up, you have to ask yourself, am I that, right? So I had to work through that with my son. Are you arrogant? Because he can be, you know, pretty harsh sometimes. He's double fire. You know, he's an Aries, Sag rising. That can be pretty intense. And they don't have a filter. And they don't speak from a heart-centered place sometimes, because that fire energy just like gets the better of them. And so I asked him, can you be arrogant? And he's like, no, because I know what I'm talking about. And so then we had to pick it apart and dissect it. Like, okay, it's actually confidence, but you know, you're not really owning that you can be confident because you're not sharing knowledge. And so that becomes a shadow aspect. But Smoky Mirror is saying, if it's showing up, is it you? Are you being shown yourself, or are you being shown something that you need to integrate about yourself and learn about yourself? Right? So like, if liars keep showing up in your reality and you're a liar, well, then you're being shown your own yourself. You're being mirrored that shadow self that is actually who you are right now. Right? But if liars keep showing up in your reality, do you have low self-worth so you're accepting way less than you deserve? Then that's what they're showing you. That's the lesson of why liars keep showing up, because it's forcing you to create boundaries around that because you deserve better. So really being aware of that. But again, when those things show up, they trigger a very specific emotion in you. Like for my son, it was rage, right? And so that rage is that solar plexus energy, that fire. And so think about those spaces in your body that are being triggered. Like if it's grief or sorrow, that's the heart, that's wind. If it's rage or even feeling betrayed or guilt, shame, that would all be solar plexus, because it's a repression of your power and tapping that down. That's that fire energy. Sacral would be the self-worth, self-doubt, unworthiness, and like the lack of abundance or creativity. That's water energy. And then fear-based thinking and lack, scarcity, that's all the root energy. That's earth. So that's how those two cards tie in. Think about those elements and those spaces in your body that are being triggered so that you can really fine-tune and excavate those parts of you that need to be healed so that you can become more whole and you can operate from a place of high integrity so that you're no longer operating from a shadow aspect of yourself and holding others captive because your intent is polluted by ego. And again, Chris Acola showed up. I mean, we've seen this so many times. I probably don't even have to tell you what the message of the card is. Like literally, this is, again, teaching that every time you speak, you are teaching others about yourself. So like I said, Janaea is here sharing this space with me. And I told her, I said, it's just like you and I talking here and I'm explaining my process to you and everything is coming out of my mouth, but it comes through the heart. I'm not thinking before I speak. And I said, so you can make all decisions about me based off of that truth. And it is the ultimate truth. If it comes through the heart, I am teaching her that I am love and that everything is in my highest integrity. My intent is pure, right? But if I come from a place of ego, then I am holding her captive and she cannot make a sound decision based off of anything because it's not truth. She's actually not even getting an authentic version of me that's giving her that information. So all decisions that she makes about me will be based off of a lie. So then everyone is held captive, even those that she shares that information about me. So you have to really think about this. This card keeps showing up. So I'm thinking, how many different ways can I talk about how to do this? I mean, pure intent comes from heart. You're not thinking before you speak. You are speaking your feels. You are speaking immediate communication about your intuition and feels. You are not holding anyone captive. You are coming clean. You are telling the truth. You are allowing people to make decisions based off of that truth. So there is no one that is sharing sacred space with you that does not have complete knowledge of who you are, because you are speaking from that place of ultimate truth and high integrity. So just think about that for a second. How many people are you holding captive? How many people do you share space with that actually know the true and authentic you because you express yourself from that place of high integrity and pure intent? How many? It should be everyone. And if it's not everyone, this card is for you. And so the last card to show up is, oh, I'll show you the stone. Lord, you've seen this damn stone so many fucking times. Look, I'll show you every fucking one this time. Whatever one you like, screenshot it and meditate with this beautiful baby. See? It's this beautiful, deep, deep green and light green and like electric blue. It's just so beautiful, this stone. And these are all raw pieces. I don't have any polished pieces of chrysocolla. Isn't that beautiful? I like that from the side view. That's really pretty. Want to see it? So, and then this last card that showed up is Elhaz, Divine Might Foretold. Now, this card is badass, and I had to read it because I've only ever seen it like one other time, but this talks about accountability, that if you are not operating from the highest intent, believe me, the universe is watching. And so even though there are some that are held captive by other people's deceit, like I said right here, they may think, how come they're not ever punished for that deceit? How come their karma like takes so long? And this card actually says, look, it doesn't matter because they're going to get theirs no matter what. Believe me, spirit is always watching. Divinity is always aware of who is in their highest integrity and who is not. And they will always, not sometimes, not just like every other time, always be held accountable for their untruths. And so anytime you operate from a place of deceit and you are holding others captive to those lies, it is not okay. And you will be held accountable for that. And it will show up in your reality and you will be held accountable. There will be a debt to pay for any untruths that you hold others captive to. And I love that. So it's basically like saying, wait for it. You'll see. Don't worry about it. As long as you are operating from pure intent, high integrity, and not holding others captive, then you're shit straight. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about anybody else because spirit's watching. They don't just concentrate on one. They concentrate on all. And so just know that. Rest easy in that. And so that is the spread for the day. And so pay attention to the feels in your body and express yourself from those feels, and everything will pan out beautifully for you. Get back in your feels and connect with those elements so that they can teach you how to heal those feels. Thank you. I love you. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you.